name is Rebecca Parsons, and I'm here to talk to you about ethical tech and how to develop a framework for thinking about applying technology ethically within your organization. So first, what do I mean by ethical tech? And when we think about technology in the past, well, if you take fraud out of the equation, something like an accounts receivable or an accounts payable system or so many aspects of technology, there just isn't an ethical component. As long as you were following the law, you're not committing fraud. Technology really wasn't good or evil in the sense of the kinds of IT systems that we work on all of the time. But that is changing. We are getting into areas where it's really not so clear what constitutes good. When you start to think about automated decisioning, it's one thing if it's a recommendation engine. Nothing goes horribly wrong just because you now get a recommendation for something that actually you don't really much want. But it's different if the decisioning is about, say, a credit matter. Then there are actually ethical considerations to take into account. And so as we expand the breadth of the applications that we are looking at for technology, we have to take these new considerations into account. Now, you might be thinking to yourself, what's so hard about that? I mean, we know we're good people. We wouldn't do anything intentionally that is unethical or bad or anything like that. So why is this so hard? Well, I was speaking with an executive, a data executive at a bank, and she said that they had undertaken an exercise to develop an ethical framework for how they handle customer data. And she said she thought it would probably take, you know, a couple of months. They were still at it almost 9 months later and just getting towards the end of the process, because when you start to think about some of these questions, you start to realize it's not that straightforward. I listened to a talk from Kathy O'Neill, the author of the book, The Weapons of Math Destruction. And there was a Q&A after her talk where they actually started delving into the issues about the potential imbalance between profitability and fairness. And in fact, you might be in a situation where you could make a model that was much more profitable for your company, but that would end up unfairly treating certain categories of people. What's the right choice there? It's not so clear cut. Also, when you look at data aggregation, a piece of data in isolation might be perfectly harmless, but tying together different sources of information can suddenly paint a picture that is far more revealing than what you might expect. And since we don't really have, therefore, a clear-cut definition for what constitutes good, we have to, as individuals, as technologists, and as organizations, go through a discussion of really what constitutes good. What do we consider ethical? What are the bounds that we are going to put around what is acceptable in our operations? So what should you do about it? The first thing is to come up with that definition of what constitutes good. How do you want to make these trade-offs? How do you look at your products, your services, the way you interact with your customers? Who are really the stakeholders? Is it simply your direct customers? Or do you also need to take into account your customers' customers? Or the broader participation in society? We have to understand who the stakeholders really are in our business before we can decide for these different groups what constitutes good. Now, there are some tools out there that can help, and I'll tell you just a little bit about some of these tools, but they're all easy to find. out there on the World Wide Web. So the first thing is to acknowledge that if you do not have diverse representation on the team considering these problems, there may be stakeholder groups that you leave completely out of consideration. I understand my experiences as a white woman. I don't have direct experience of what it means to be a Dalit class woman in India. And maybe that's part of my stakeholder group. So we need to, as we're taking into account what constitutes good and how different groups will be impacted by the decisions that we make, we need to start from the position of at least attempting to understand not just our own perspectives, but the perspectives of our entire community. There's something called the ethical operating system. And what that has is a series of probing questions that allow you to start to tease out what some unintended consequences might be and some strategies that you might employ to understand what those consequences might be and how you might mitigate against them. We can look at extending the concept of threat modeling to thinking about these unintended consequences. We normally hear about threat modeling from the perspective of security and cybersecurity threats. But what you do in threat modeling is you look at your assets and what possible actors there might be that would be participating in some activity that might actually constitute a threat. And you can use threat modeling exercises to start to get a handle on what might be the impacts on some of these other groups, rather than just your typical expected audience. There's a method called consequences scanning, which first takes you through a process to try to understand what your intended consequences are, but also start to uncover, once again, those unintended consequences, and takes you through a process where you can find those consequences that you want to amplify, because these are positive consequences. And also what mitigation strategies there might be for you to mitigate against unintended negative consequences to one of your stakeholder groups. And finally, there's something called the tarot cards of tech. And again, these are cards that help probe a design or probe a system to try to tease out what some of those unintended consequences might be and trigger thinking about how you might deal with a particular problem or what consequences a different stakeholder group might experience as a result of your product. So all of these different approaches help you really understand what the impact of your technology might be. This is a quote that I've seen many different times about whether or not technology in and of itself is ethical or moral. And this is the assertion that it's only when we apply technology that it becomes good or evil, because that's where that good or evil manifests itself. My proposal here is for you to take into account, as you're dealing with technology, what that application might look like and what the consequences of that application are to your breadth of stakeholders, so that we don't fall into the trap of creating something evil when we don't intend to. It's not that the technology is evil, it is how we use it, and we can make the choice to apply it in a way that only does good and does not do evil. Thank you very much.